In this video, I am going to discuss with you the concept of loop. Why we need a loop in the programming? In programming, as we have to repeat a number of statements sometimes, to remove that repetitions, we make the use of the loop statements. A number of loop statements are for, while, and do while. Most of the programming languages provide us the feature of working with these loop statements. For the time being, I will try to go for the simplest version of the for, right? But prior to that, why we have to go for a loop? Let's go for its basics, right? As I have already told you that in case we have to repeat the statements, to remove the repetition of these statements, we have the option of using a loop. Let's say I write the program containing printf hello, and I write it 100 times. Right, 1, 2, 100 times. So what the result I will get? I will get this hello to be printed 100 times. That is my output, right? So what I can do, instead of writing it 100 times, can I make it as a part of a loop? Can I go for a loop as this is the one statement that I am going to repeat again and again and again? So what I can do, I can make it as a part of the body of a loop, like this, and close this with the head of a loop statement. For example, I am going to make the use of the loop statement, that is for. Provide the things in this in such a way that it executes 100 times. So next, what I have to do, I have to clear this. Right, to clear these things, you must be clear with the two words. One is called syntax, and another one is semantic. What do you know by syntax? Syntax is the way to write a statement in any programming language. For example, in case I want to write the printf. This is the way, right? This is the way. Right? Printf, double quotes, having hello, followed by semicolon. But how it's, what its interpretation is in the programming language, that is C. Printf is a function, what its job is, take this as an input and give it to the monitor, and this is a complete statement. So what is this? This is a terminator. So I think, I hope this two words are clear in the context to the printf hello. Next, let's move to the concept of loop. Using loop, I will try to clear the word, this syntax and semantic, right? What the syntax of a for loop in any of the programming languages, or in most of the programming languages? For, followed by a bracket pair having two semicolon. This is called the head, right? And this is called the body. As we already know from the previous example, what we write here, we write those statements that we are going to repeat again and again, that we want our system to execute many times, and many times are fixed by the head, right? And this is the syntax. But what the semantic is, how it works, how this for works, let's say this is a statement first. Of course, semicolon is there, so I will say this is a statement first. This is a statement 2. This is a statement 3. This is a body. I will call it as a statement 4. For the semantic, I will say for the 4, I will clear you with the help of the flowchart. The very first statement that is executed in the head of the for loop is the statement 1, followed by the statement 2. In case this statement 2 returns true, the body will be executed, or the statement 4 is executed. Once this set of statement or a statement that is in body is executed, the flow goes to, flow is there, the flow goes to the block 2 or the statement 2, and till the time, oh my god, so once the step 1 is executed, then it moves to the second statement, and that statement is executed. In case that statement returns true, then the body is executed. Right? After the execution of the body, it moves to the block 3 or the statement 3, right? Which is, I will call as an iteration. Let's fill up this as well. The block 1 is called initialization, second is called condition, and the third one is called iteration, followed by the body. But the semantic is, the step 1 is in the very first step, initialization is executed, then it moves to the second, which where condition is executed, and condition returns either true or false, followed by, in case the condition returns true, it goes to the body. Once the body is executed, it goes to the block 3 or the statement 3, where iteration takes place. And after the iteration, it comes back to the statement 2. So it checks the condition. If the condition is true again, it keeps on repeating. That's why we call it a loop. Once the condition returns false, it exits the loop. It goes out of the loop. So this is all about the semantic of the loop, of the for loop. Let's go for its example. I want to print hello 10 times. So again, I am writing the same statement, printf hello. This is the body that I want to repeat again and again. So I have phrased it as printf hello followed by the semicolon. Then what I want this to be repeated 10 times. So this thing is clear. You have to provide three statements here. The statement 1, statement 2, statement 3, and statement 4. 4 you have already provided, right? Then you have to write something in this head so that the body execute 10 times. So what I can do for the initialization, I can make the use of a variable. I have initialized the value of I equal to 0, right? Then I know this is the first statement that is going to be executed. I equal to 0. What I want something here that make this, that give this result as true. So what I can write I equal to 100. It is randomly, I am not fixing it with 10, 20, 100, right? I have just fixed it as 100, right? Later on, I will make the modification according to my requirement, right? Once this is executed, I equal to 0, then 0 is less than equal to. I have to use the operator that give me the result as 2 false or 0 1, right? 0, I equal to 0, 0 is less than 100, give me the result as true or 1. So this body will be executed. Once this body is executed, it will come here. So what I have to write here, I equal to I plus 1 और i इक्वल टू i माइनस वन. I can write both, but which should I write here? I plus 1 or I minus 1? I can write any, but what I must write? I must write something that converges these two, so it takes the value of I toward this 100. This is not the statement that can take it. So this is the one statement that I can write it. Right? If I write this statement into the head, I equal to 0, I is less than equal to 100, I equal to I plus 1, followed by this body. Let's see what will be the working of this for loop. This is the first statement that is going to be executed. So I will say I equal to 0. I is less than equal to 100. Yes. So it is giving me the value as true. 0 is less than equal to 100. So it will enter into the body. So the hello will be the result. Hello will be the printer. Right? Once this 4 is executed, then it will move to the iteration, that is the third. So what it will make it? I equal to I plus 1. Will make it I as 1. 1 is less than 100. Yes, it is true. So again, printf will work. It will keep on printing it 100 times. What our requirement was? It will print it 100 times or 101 time? Please check this out. Right? But if I make it 10, so I hope it will print it 10 times or 11 times. Again, you have to check it. Instead of that, if I write it keeping all the same, I write it I is less than equal to 0. How many times it will work? I equal to 0? It will go here. 0 is less than equal to 0. Yes, that is true. Printf will work. Then I's value will become 1. 1 is less than 0. Is that true or false? I hope that is false. So it will not work. It will take you out of the loop. So it will work only one time. So the result will be a single hello. Right? I hope using this very simple example, I am able to clear you the concept of for loop.